is Dr. Lucas Brazill. I have the largest YouTube channel in the world about tricolage with over 150 million views. In order to bring more information and tips about hair loss and aesthetics and health to the whole world, I created a version of the videos in English. Welcome and enjoy. Do you like wearing a cap or helmet and you want to know if it really causes hair loss? Is the cap a cause of hair loss? That's what I want to talk about to you today in this video. A very controversial issue, and one of that people ask a lot about, is the use of a cap, hat and helmet. Does it really cause hair loss? This is a very old story. It started back in 1868 when a doctor assumed this theory that the cap, or at that time that the hat, occluded the blood vessels in the scalp, causing a reduction in the circulation. Then he raised this hypothesis in relation to the cap or hat of the time with the reduction of the blood flow and baldness. And this story lasted for a long time, for more than 9 years. And it was all around 1946 that science discovered that the relation that existed between baldness and other factors that were not the cap. That person who likes to wear a cap and who wears the cap very often may be aggravating the heat in the head and increasing dermatitis, for example. And that scalp that is very inflamed, it's very damage, it can increase the hair loss. But it's very important to point out that the person who already has the genetic origin for baldness, he will have to take care of this whole life of that. The cap is perhaps an aggravating one, not the cause. People confuse this a lot. For example, stress. Sometimes the stress can be caused, but usually stress is just an aggravating factor for hair loss. So this is our opinion in relation to wearing a cap. It may be causing more inflammation, making dermatitis worse, and this dermatitis will cause their hair loss. But not necessarily that person who has no predisposition, has no irritation, and has no problem to baldness. In addition to the fact that it decreases the sebum, and we have already seen here in the channel that sebum, that greasiness mainly in men who suffer from baldness, sebum is extremely harmful, and the friction may be increasing this sebum. So it's good to avoid that. Sebum contains a lot of DHT, the baldness hormone. I hope you like this video. Subscribe to receive every week new videos. Follow us on Instagram and Facebook. There's a lot of tips there too. Would like to know more about our products? Check out our description, your website, and see the eclairword.com. Thanks for watching. Here's Dr. Lucas Brazill. See you in the next videos.